This is Duke University.
My name is Mari Jørstad. I'm in the Graduate Department of Religion. I'm a PhD candidate. I wanted to study the Hebrew Bible. Duke has a very strong program, and a number of the professors here had studied with the professors at my master's institute. I'm particularly interested in ecological reading of scripture. Most students who want to learn biblical Hebrew are doing it either because they want to study the Bible academically or because they're becoming pastors. It's a way of enriching their preaching life. When they're looking at a text, they can look at the original Hebrew, see nuances that might be hard to see in the English translation.
There were a lot of just creative guesses.
So the main goal of the class is that students should become competent to read biblical Hebrew. So practically what that means is that we spend a lot of time learning basic grammar. So students learn the different verbal forms, they learn to tell the difference between a noun and a verb, they have to learn a lot of vocabulary. So a lot of it is sort of very nitty-gritty memorization things.
He'emat.
He'emat.
He'emati.
He'emati.
So it's sort of like becoming familiar with a very different way of structuring language.
The internet is not entirely on our side. There we go.
So we're... The
Lord. Yeah, the Lord. It's true.
As a teacher, it's easier just to have my students memorize things because that asks very little of me, right? I can say, memorize page 190, they go home and do it. That means that students tend not to learn it that well. They memorize the list of uses of a verbal form for a test, they take the test, they immediately forget it. So much of what they do is to learn from textbooks. So they learn things that other people have discovered. If they have done an exercise where they themselves have discovered a particular use of a verbal form, it tends to stick much better. Students are using a software called Accordance to get more hands-on experience with the language. So rather than learning that a verbal form has these three uses from a textbook, students use the software to find all the instances where that verbal form is used. And so it gives them a much more hands-on experience of the language. It more closely models what scholars would do when they're looking at Hebrew. PhD Lab is supporting my current project in terms of developing a particular pedagogy for teaching biblical Hebrew. My research is about texts in which things like trees, mountains, waterways act like persons in some way. Accordance lets me search for very specific things without having to read all of that text. At one point, I needed to know if the word for earth or land was the subject of verbs like to swallow, to speak, or to vomit, things having to do with mouth. So instead of having to read the whole Hebrew Bible in Hebrew, which would take me months, I could just set up a search that would let me look at those particular kinds of phrases to create data sets, basically. What the PhD lab is encouraging in terms of its support of teaching is to really think about how teachers can use technology to provide a better learning experience for students. So they provide feedback and suggestions for how to improve it, a community that I can share my work with. Often in the humanities, there's some resistance to using technology. We tend to be very text-based or image-based, and it just takes a lot of time to learn new technologies. So it's kind of like when you buy a new digital camera, and you get overwhelmed with all the buttons, so in the end you just like learn how to do the automatic thing. The learning curve is quite steep, and it's different from the kinds of things that humanists usually are trained to learn. Seeing other people's research and how they're using different tools, that lets me get a much broader sense of the possibilities, so that I take part of the responsibility of thinking about what is the best way for students to learn this, not just what is our way.
Produced by Duke University, online at duke.edu.